Hey guys, we are back for day three of Foundation Week. I hope you have enjoyed the week so far. Day one was dry skin foundations. Day two was oily skin foundations. I will link day two up in a card. I think it's over here. I don't know. And today we're gonna be talking about cream foundations. Y'all, I don't talk much about cream foundations on my channel, and I don't know why, because I do wear them and I do use them. And I do like them. One of these I have talked and raved about, and so you probably could guess what it is. But the other one, I don't know that I've talked at all about them. So this will be a fun new video for everybody. Okay, so cream foundations are typically formulated with normal to dry skin types in mind. A lot of times they can tend to slide off more combo oily skins. And they are a little bit more finicky with application because I find that cream foundations have a much thinner line between looking good and way too much than liquid foundations do. So because of that, I'm gonna tell you how I apply each of these because a lot of them have different application methods that I find work best. Again, a lot of them are marketed for normal to dry skin, but I'm gonna tell you the ones that I think are suitable for combo oily skin too. As always, with even a liquid foundation, but especially cream foundation, if you do have comboed oily skin, I do think it's imperative to prime properly with whatever primer you find best for your skin that holds foundations on the longest. I personally don't find that cream foundations need any type of different kind of primers than liquids do. So whatever, you know, primer you find works best for your oily skin with your liquid foundations, I would suggest definitely using with your cream foundation. Now saying that, if you have normal to dry skin, a lot of times I don't find that cream foundations need a primer. Sometimes if you have big pores, they can accentuate them a little bit more than a liquid. So because of that, I typically don't prime except for right here on my pores and my nose. And so I use something like the, sorry, my fan's higher than it normally is and it's blowing all in my face. I use something like the DHC Velvet Skin Coat, which I'm using today. It's a super, super dimethicone based primer, but it really fills in pores beautifully and every foundation goes over it flawlessly. So again, I just put that around my pores, but I don't find the need to prime anywhere else. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to talk about my top favorite cream foundation. Foundation number one. This is a foundation that I keep in my kit. I have a couple of palettes, but I'm just gonna show you this one because it was the easiest one for me to pull out. And it is the Cinema Secrets Pro Cosmetics Foundation. Now these come in 5-pan palettes like this. You can get these on Sephora, but of course you can also get them on more professional websites like Camera Ready Cosmetics, Nigel's, Namie's, stuff like that. They come with a little tiny little concealer brush type thing. And this is the number 300 series, and it's for light to medium yellow beige undertones. So this is just the aesthetic of my clients, the majority of my clients. I do have a much darker palette, the darkest that they carry with the undertones. I think 100 is red undertones and 200 maybe golden undertones. In the case that I do have a darker skin client. These I like to take out with a spatula for sanitary reasons, scoop it out, put it on a palette, kind of warm it up with my finger because the heat of your fingers really do help to warm up foundations. And then I will take very minimal amount. And like I said, cream foundations have that very fine line that you can jump over really quick to put too much on your face. So put a very minimal amount and I like to buff it out with a brush. Something like the Real Techniques contour brush works really well with this. And the more you buff it, the better I think it looks on the skin. So again, you need the very tiniest amount. This is one that I think if you prime properly will work on combo oily skin. It stays all day long. It does have a little bit more of a dewy finish. I do find, I don't want to say dewy, maybe radiant. I do find that cream foundations as a whole have more of that finish. There's going to be two that I talk about that don't, but as a whole, they have more of a radiant to at least natural finish versus a matte finish. So again, that one is one that I like to keep in my kit. I do use it on clients, and I find also that it works great for cream contouring and cream highlighting. So you can also get, you know, colors appropriate for that if that's your intention with the product. That goes for pretty much any cream foundation. The second one I'm going to talk about is, no, it's the second to most luxe foundation that I'm going to talk about today, and it is the Cure Weiss foundation. I think this is the only foundation that Cure Weiss carries. Cure Weiss is a, is she Danish? Maybe. I feel like she's Danish, but I may be wrong. She's a makeup artist, and she is very into green beauty and natural products. So she has formulated her own line of cosmetics, and it is all organic natural products. So this is the only, well, no, it's not the only natural one I'm going to talk about, but this is one of them. This is the heaviest packaging I have in any product ever. This is very luxe, very, I don't know. This is like, just feel like special getting this out for some reason. This is like the Tom Ford of the green beauty scene. Very, very heavy packaging. It is refillable. So this pan will pop out. There is a little hole in the back where you can do that, as all of her products do. And you can just buy the refill pans. This is in the color Just Sheer. So it's a little bit lighter. It doesn't look lighter than I use right now, but it is just a tad lighter. This one is a little bit thicker than the other ones I'm going to talk about. So because of that, it just looks like skin going on. Because of that, I like to apply it with a foundation brush. So this is just like a little travel Bobbi Brown foundation brush. I like to put it in the product, pick a little bit up, stipple it on my face, and then kind of just blend it in that way. You can go back over it with a sponge, but just know that that will sheer out the product just a little bit. It is a very natural finish on the skin. It's really skin-like. It's very buildable. I don't find that you need a lot. So again, with everything, start out with the smallest amount possible. But because this is very expensive, I would suggest maybe just buying the refill first. I mean, I'm glad I bought this because I like it, but because you don't know if you will, I would suggest finding a retailer that has a return policy. I believe Detox Market might, I'm not sure. Definitely research that, and then probably just buy the refill so that you're not spending $20 more for the packaging when you might not end up liking it anyways. And then you can always go back and buy, you know, another one if you wanted to get the actual packaging. But I do really enjoy that foundation, especially it being organic and natural. The next one I'm going to talk about is the one that I have on my face today. And I don't think I've ever worn this in it. Well, I've worn it in videos, but I don't think I've ever talked about it or done a tutorial with it. I need to change that. It's the Gerda Spilman Biofon Foundation. These are the smaller packaging. I have the color Praline, which is this color right here, and Bijou, which is this color. So Praline is just a little bit lighter than Bijou, if you can see. So Praline and Bijou. For days like today, where I'm like on the tail end of my self-tan and I really haven't been outside since I've gotten home from vacation, I mix the two. In the winter, I just use Praline, and in the dead of summer when I'm the most tan, I just use Bijou. Now, this one is a little bit, hold just one second. Hello? Okay, sorry about that. I'm not quite sure where I left off, but I do find this to be a much creamier version of the other cream foundations I've talked about. So because of that, I like to go straight in with the Beauty Blender, and I will just tap it in and then tap it on my face. This is super full coverage. You do not need a lot of product. I barely hit put a dent in this, and I used it quite a bit. And really and truly, I think I went back in one time after my initial product on the Beauty Blender to get the coverage that I have on my face today. It's a really nice foundation. It just lays really well on the skin. Again, it blends in with the skin to where it doesn't sit on it and make it look cakey or look like you have foundation on. It can look like that again, but if you just put on what you need, I think you're going to be absolutely floored with the coverage and the finish. It's a very natural finish. It does lean more towards radiant, but it's a radiant that I don't even feel like I need to set. Like today, I just set in my T-zone and it really doesn't go anywhere. Now it's super hot. If you're oily, you may want to definitely set everywhere, but it's just a really pretty foundation, and I like it for filming too because it is great for camera work. So love that one. The next two I apply with the same brush, so I will show you that in a minute. This one I talked about when I was packing for my vacation, and I need to buy the full size so that I can do a review for y'all. It's so good. This is another green beauty product, a natural organic product, and it's from the company called All Natural. And they sent me this stack, kind of sampler stack, which they have for purchase on their website. And I think it's an ingenious idea because you get three colors of their foundation based on what skin tone you pick. So I picked medium. So I have three of their medium foundations, a cream blush, a cream bronzer, and their finishing powder. The finishing powder is so good. Like, I'm buying that too. But it is, oh my goodness. I don't know if I posted it on Instagram yet, but I plan on it, so I'll go ahead and do a little sneak peek. I took a picture when I was wearing this. I wore this on the flight home from Florida, and it lasted from like literally 8 o'clock that morning till 2 o'clock in the morning because our flight was delayed coming home. And I don't need that much, so I just take a little spatula to get it out. They come in stick form, so when I get the full size, you can just actually draw it on your face. And I like to buff it in with the IT Cosmetics Heavenly Luck Complexion Perfection brush. One of the reasons I like this, other than the fact that it buffs it out beautifully, is the fact that it does have this other end too, which if I need to like get around my brows or in my nose, I can just put that little side in and get it easily. Again, it will come with a stick, but even the stick is going to be about this circumference, so you can easily put this on the stick and be able to get into smaller areas. You can also cream contour with this. You can also highlight with this as a concealer. If I had a lighter color, I would definitely wear it as a concealer. It's that pretty on the skin. It is probably the most skin-like that I'm going to talk about today out of the cream foundations, tied with the next one that I'm going to talk about. It just lays so beautifully, and for an organic green brand, it is one of the longest lasting foundations. I love it. You can build it up. You can spot conceal. It's just so good. I cannot wait to get the full size, and that powder too is like perfection. Okay, let's talk about my last one. This is the one that you have heard me talk about before and that I absolutely adore. I think I said I was gonna put it in my top five. If I didn't, I am, because it's that good. It is the Tom Ford Traceless Stick Foundation. I'm in the color 6.5 Sable. Let me tell you real quick what color I am in this. I am most suited toward Lucia in the All Natural. Okay, the Tom Ford in Sable. This I have done a whole video on, so I will link it in a card, because there's really not much that I didn't say in that video that I could say about it now. It is very skin-like. It will probably make it into another video this week. I said the Face Atelier was the only one that was gonna double up. I lied, this is gonna double up too. It is super long-lasting, and honestly, up until I tried the All Natural, which comes in a stick version, this was the only stick foundation that I really liked. Like, I wasn't a huge fan of the Hourglass. I wasn't a huge fan of the Lancome. What other ones have I tried that I wasn't a huge fan of? I didn't get along well with stick foundations until this. Now, this is another one that I feel like if you have combo oily skin, you can wear if you prime well, because it is so long lasting. Also with the All Natural, it's just so good. Like, all skin types, it's so expensive. I understand that. It's definitely a luxury product. This is even more expensive than the Cure Weiss. But I've used it a ton. Like a ton. And you can see it's only down that far. So you don't need that much. And I do feel like it's going to last a long time. And it does have 0.5 ounces, which compared to other stick foundations is quite a lot of product. So I just, again, really suggest that you go watch that video, because it's absolutely flawless on the skin, and I cannot recommend it enough. So those are my top favorite cream foundations. Hopefully this gave you some new ideas, since some of them I've never talked about. And if you want any separate videos on the ones that I have not talked about, please let me know, and I will add that to my list of things to film in the future. Stay tuned for tomorrow's video, because we are going to be talking about the most skin-like foundations, which I'm really excited about, because that's my favorite type of foundation to wear. I want it to look like skin. So be sure and stay tuned for that, and subscribe and like if you haven't already so you don't miss out on any of that. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all go out and have a very blessed day.